Interestingly, although cloud computing is a relatively new trend, as a vision, it existed for a very long time. The oldest description by John McCarthy predates the technology by almost half a century, and it appeared in 61. He said the following: "If computers of the kind I have advocated become the computers of the future, then computing may someday be organized as a public utility, just as the telephone system is a public utility. The computer utility could become the basis of a new and important future." If we look at this statement, it describes a vision where computing is a utility just like other utilities. If we need more electricity, we just turn the switch on. We don't worry about where the electricity actually comes from. Based on this vision, cloud computing should turn the IT resource into a fungible utility, where we don't care about what type of CPUs or disk are ultimately used or where they are. Virtualization technology is one enabler in the process, certainly. Unfortunately, there are still limitations before this vision of just seamless computing utility can be realized. For instance, even with virtualization, there are still some hardware dependencies that simply cannot be masked. So if software expects a certain type of hardware platform to execute, then we cannot just have it run on another type of resource. Then there is the API lock-in, where if we're using a particular cloud provider, then we're expected to continue using those APIs. There isn't a uniform standard across cloud providers. And then, unlike with some of these other utilities where we're simply bringing data, this resource, the electricity, in the case of cloud computing, we're putting data, potentially core business services, out in the cloud. So some of the privacy and security concerns become much more important. Clearly, latency is an issue given that there is an actual geographic distance related to our accesses to a remote cloud.